guys, welcome back to Warren Mechanics. In today's video, guys, here we'll be working here on a BMW 3 Series Generation 2005-2013. This one will be 90, E91, 92, 93. And we'll show you how to remove and replace spark plugs on this car. So, if you need help with that, and you're about to remove and replace yours, stay with us and we'll show you how to do that now. The procedure is not very complicated, but what we'll need to do, we'll need to start removing that cover here so we can access all six spark plugs, and we'll show you why. So let's start on that thing now. I forgot to mention that we have more than 200 videos on this car, so please guys, subscribe to the channel for more videos, and if you need help with anything, drop a comment below. So let's start now. So all the tools and parts that we use will be listed in the description of the video below. We need 8mm socket, and we'll need to go ahead and remove that bolt. This is for the cabin air filter. Okay, we're supposed to have the same bolt on this side, but one is missing on this side. We're going to install some later. We just noticed that. Okay, we have one more on this side, and again, one is missing. So all together you need to have one, two, three, four bolts. Now you can pull your cabin air filter out. Okay, that's what it looks like. And we can proceed with the next step. So now you can find this one, I'll list in the description of the video. This is a very handy tool for what we'll be doing next. Okay, we need to disconnect the wiring harness from here. So on the inside there is one clip. I'm going to show it to you in just a second once we remove it, because it's hard to... Okay, it's a little bit hard to see there. So let me just get the thing in. Okay, they came loose. Now you have those clips right here. Okay, check it out. And these clips, you need to go ahead and push them down, okay, with that thing. And when you push them down, you can pull the wiring harness out of the holders there. So you have three of them. One, two, three. Usually they don't come off so easy, but we removed them in the past. Probably that's why they came out a little bit easier this time. Next, we need to go ahead, okay, and remove that cover. You have two clips, one on this side, one on the other one. Exactly the same. After that, pull that rubber seal out and the cap will come off. The same thing on this side. Okay, pull that rubber thing out. One clip here, one over there. Okay, and we're going to pull the cap as well. We need to use the 8mm socket again. And let's go on this side now. There is one bolt that we need to remove. Okay, we'll need to disconnect our air quality sensor as well. So we just get it out of the clips like that. And now we need to remove the same bolt on this side with 8mm socket. Okay, perfect. Now you can see right here we have two rubber things that we need to pull out, one on this side, one on the other side. And after that you're going to pull this thing up on the front end and slide it back. And now you're going to see how much more room we're going to get to work on the engine here. Next, we can grab the engine cover and pull it straight up. Okay, there is a few rubber bushings holding it in place. Okay, let's flip it on the side and I'll show you. Four rubber bushings, one, two, three, four. And those bushings attach to the valve cover right here. You can see two spots and two over there. So now, with that cover out of the way, you can see we can reach each of the individual ignition coils, and there is a spark plug under each of the ignition coils. So this is cylinder number 1, 2, 3, then you have 4, 5 and 6. Now, the procedure for removing and replacing spark plug is the same on each cylinder, okay, the same procedure, so we'll just show on one guy so we don't waste your time. Okay, and we will do cylinder number 3 in our case because it's more of a limited room there, okay. Let me turn the light on. We'll go ahead, open right here. Okay, you need to pull the cable out. And after that, you pull the ignition coil straight up. Okay, you can turn it a little bit left and right to get it loose and pull it out. But do not twist this way. Just turn a little bit if you need to and pull straight out. Now we will need a socket for spark plugs, 5/8. Okay, that all we'll be using now. Extension, and we'll remove the spark plug. Okay, now sometimes if your spark plug socket doesn't hold it, what you can do, you can get the ignition coil and push it in on top of the spark plug, grab the spark plug and pull the spark plug out. Okay, you can see it just like that. I would recommend to get a socket that can pull them out. This is because when you are ready to install them, you want to make sure that you gently put the spark plug in, because if you drop it, you will hit the bottom of it and the gap will be off. So that's how we guys remove the spark plugs on that thing. You can check out in the description of the video where we usually buy our parts and tools from, so don't forget to do that for your convenience. Installation, everything is in reverse order. If you need the torque specs, okay, we will have a video on the channel for the torque specs, so please check it out. Thank you for watching, guys. Please subscribe to the channel and see you guys next time.